Hey, how's it going? Jay here. I got an email earlier this evening that I thought seemed kind of strange. I just wanted to post this. It arrived. It said I have received a encrypted email to my Gmail there, and I was like, okay, well, what's that? So I click on it. It brings me to this Tuda notice site, and email says, I noticed you uploaded a video claiming that X is directly interfering with the proliferation of your content algorithmically. In short, yes, we are. Well, I should say they, as I am no longer employed by X. I have been watching your channel because it appears often for certain keywords that it is a developer for X. We're on a list of key terms and quotations that was distributed to our department right before COVID began. I never dealt with you personally, but I know X and other X's and O's are following a similar directive. It is like they are trying to stamp out something digitally that they do not want people in the analog world to realize is happening. I wouldn't say I believe in God, but after researching these topics the last several years, I am genuinely afraid for myself and my children. I wish I could help you spread the word about this, but I work for another X with close ties to the former X, and I can't risk losing my job, which I understand that I've been freaking unemployed for like 4 months. Anyways, have a good night. So I got that earlier, you know, that's where it showed up in my Gmail. What was kind of weird was, like, I mean, she had my personal email, which, I mean, you can find that if you dig around a little bit. It's not like I've tried ever hiding my real name, but it was funny that she spent the time to do that. I'm assuming it's female, because it's probably male. It came from an email. I just said crypto chick, but it's probably a dude that made a fake chick account, because that's what I would do, just to further obfuscate everything. But I just thought that was kind of weird, you know. And at the end there, she says, I wish there was a way I could help you. Well, I mean, there is, you know, like, I'm assuming what she was getting at was, like, she wishes she could, or he or she could come out publicly and say, yeah, this is happening, but they don't want to lose their job, because I'm sure they're probably out in California or something, and, you know, those companies all deal with each other, because they're all secretly owned by, like, the same super mega corporation that's owned by whoever, probably the devil or something, because he's been around a long time. I imagine he's been using his time effectively, unlike some people. But what was I getting at? Oh yeah, if you actually want to help, like she said, if you want to help me, you know, spread this word, just share my freaking channel, or just tell people. You don't even have to mention my channel. You know, just mention this. Like, some guy on the internet was saying this bunch of weird crap's happening, and, you know, people should pay more attention to what's happening around them, because he's worried, you know, for everyone. I'm assuming these things are real, and I'm not just worried about, like, people or whatever. I'm worried about everything, you know. I don't, if God, if they're real, that means God's real, and if God's real, that means there's a really, really powerful being that can destroy the entire universe. And, I mean, they can easily destroy the world. Hell, they might even be able to destroy the universe, too. I don't really know. But what I do know is we got, like, two very, very powerful forces butting heads with one another, and we're stuck in the middle of all this, and none of us asked to be here. You know, none of us ever asked to be, you know, born and have to deal with all of this. You know, so, you know, I'm a Taoist. You know, I believe in a lot of the stuff Christ did, because, you know, I kind of think he was a Taoist too, but, I mean, far preferred by me than the Bible or any other, you know, book of Judeo-Christian or any other religious theology or philosophy. The Tao Te Ching, I mean, if you never read the Tao, you know, read that over and over again. And if after reading it and learning, you know, what it's trying to teach, I mean, if you do not feel love for every sentient being in the universe after reading that book enough times so it actually sinks in, so you're not just scoffing at it. Like, I didn't really click with it when I had first heard of it in high school. I read a book called the Tao Poo, which it's Taoism explained through the eyes of Winnie the Pooh. Let me pull it up. It's a really cute book, and, you know, and I had read it when I was a teenager. A friend of mine gave it to me. But you know, I thought it was cute, but I never really, you know, paid much mind to it. That was the edition that my friend had given me. Fantastic book, though. I've actually I reread this since I began reading the Tao Te Ching and reread it. You know, because I better understand Taoism. And what I first thought was just kind of like a cutesy, you know, lighthearted book is actually one of the most in-depth books on philosophy and psychology and just life in general that you could ever find, which is why this is being sold on the Harvard bookstore. I mean, this is a seemingly, you know, childish book. I mean, that's Winnie the Pooh right there, you know, dressed up in Chinese, ancient China, Chinese clothes, flying a kite with the yin-yang symbol there. But I mean, it's a beautiful, beautiful book. And I'm fairly certain, like, I have intelligence organizations monitoring my channel. Getting this email kind of makes me feel like, yeah, I definitely am at this point. So I'm going out on a limb here thinking that, you know, there's Chinese intelligence agents that watch my channel. And if you guys do, I just wanted to say your culture is one of the most fascinating cultures in human history. And Taoism is one of the great treasures of ancient China, you know. And if you're trying to reestablish your golden age, you know, why not take the Tao into consideration? You know, it's a philosophy that brings about prosperity for everyone, you know, an enjoyment of existence for everyone, you know, without having to compromise anything, you know. And I highly recommend that anybody listening to this reads both the Tao of Pooh, and there's another one about Piglet, his little piggy buddy. I think it's called, like, it's not the Tao of Piglet. I think it's called The Way, like Wu Wei, like effortless effort. But I think the Day of Piglet, yeah, which is like saying the Tao. But both those books, as well as the Tao Te Ching itself by Lao Tzu, this is my favorite book ever written. This is literally the wisest man in human history would have to be this man here, and no one knows who he was. It's not even, his name most likely wasn't even Lao Tzu. Translated, that it means the old boy. So his identity is uncertain, but it is said that he was a contemporary of both Buddha and Confucius, which they very well could have been contemporaries alive at the same time. Those three philosophies have influenced, you know, the Asian, and to this nowadays the Western world as well, have influenced the culture tremendously. And I really think right now more than ever, moving our energies towards the Tao would offer great improvement and peace and continued prosperity, and would give those that lust for power something that actually satisfies that urge for power and wealth that you never can fill. You will never, no matter, and it talks about this in the Tao, that it's like digging a hole, you know. The pursuit of that, it just gets bigger and bigger, and the more you try to fill it, it's just a bottomless pit. I mean, it's literally like trying to shovel dirt into a black hole. You're never going to feel free of all that stress, you know, all that stuff that makes you act this way, all that anger and tension. It all goes away. If I wasn't paranoid about being freaking kidnapped and murdered by a death cult that hates me because I exist, apparently, which kind of sucks, I guess. You know, that's pretty shitty. I don't really understand why anybody would have a problem with me. I try to be cool with everyone. But regardless, If it wasn't for all that stress in my life, you know, because that's hard to deal with. That stuff's hard to deal with. If it was just normal, everyday, mundane stress, like, boy, how am I going to pay the bills? I would be completely content with life. But, you know, the whole, like, you know, having to sleep with various self-defense objects every night, wearing, like, full body armor and SWAT gear. I mean, that's how paranoid I am. I literally sleep with, like, body armor and weapons and stuff now because I'm legit terrified, you know. And I would have stopped talking about this a long time ago, you know, out of fear, but they keep messing with me. And this is literally the only thing I can think of that's given me any sort of protection is the fact that if I die, it's going to make a digital martyr out of me. And people are going to begin suspecting, you know, that what I was talking about was actually factual. Okay, now, you guys notice, if you're still with me, I've been posting a lot more content lately. I'm going to try to stick with this on a daily basis from now on, because I am terribly worried. I'm terrified, in all honesty. Okay, I've been chain smoking, it's vape, but I used to take 2 or 3 hits off my vape a day, just to, you know, keep me from craving cigarettes. Now, I hit that thing constantly now. You know, because I'm just literally just so stressed out over all of this, and I just cannot even begin to comprehend why anybody would be targeting me specifically, considering the fact that I'm not saying anything that no other conspiracy theorist that's into this stuff as much as I am has said previously. I don't know why these things revealed themselves to me specifically. I've been trying to find out if other people discussing this stuff have had similar experiences. I did actually speak to a guy from the Rise channel. He's got about 300,000-400,000 subscribers. I messaged him about some of the things I had seen, and he's told me a gentleman on a channel called Sticks and Stones, which I was unable to find, but he said it's got a few 100,000 subscribers on there as well, but he had a similar experience as I, with a white skinned giant, you know. So I talked to a guy when I was in county jail for this made up trespassing case I was set up on, pretty much just to, you know, ruin my life. I lost my job, my apartment, my vehicle, all my tools. It literally financially destroyed me. It was right in the middle of COVID. I got out of jail after 3 months of sitting there with, you know, they finally dropped the charge. They wouldn't lower my bail. They put me in at $50,000 bail for trespassing and wouldn't lower it. But so I got stuck there. I lost my car, my apartment, you know, everything I owned. And I at this point, I honestly think that they did that to me deliberately, solely to financially cripple me, to prevent me from having any type of budget to talk to try to spread this message to as many people as I possibly can. You know, their assumption was, I guess it was, I was going to start telling people what I had seen because I have a big mouth. And yes, I do. And that is because my death will prove this stuff is real. And my sincere hope is that this isn't hell and everyone else is in on it, and I'm literally the only person that doesn't know what is going on. Because if that's the case, like, that's pretty fucked up. That's like some amazing commitment to just fucking with someone's head, and totally reminds me of the Rick and Morty episode, the simulation episode, with the intergalactic scammers, Zygerion. This episode here, super goofy episode. I love Rick and Morty. I don't know about you guys, but it's a great show.
Use these processors to make some real important science stuff. If you watched enough of it,
into conspiracy stuff, they talk about a lot of weird occult stuff on the show. The code, right? Like a lot of the stuff that they're putting in TV nowadays. It's like a soft disclosure, because if it's in a cartoon, who's going to believe it's real? But they can't resist their urge to tell someone that they're doing it. And they think we're all stupid, too. Gosh, it's on Netflix. I highly recommend this show. This is such a funny show that I actually subscribed to Netflix. Inside Job is what it's called. Like, this show, I mean, it's just such over-the-top conspiracy crap. But the funny thing
have
is,
you ever wondered this
show
really
that's literally, the show, okay, this show is literally made to be insanely over-the-top conspiracy stuff, just such crazy crap. And the funny thing is, it's talking about stuff that I was talking about on my channel, my old channel, 4 or 5 years before it came out. And now they're acting like, oh, look how crazy this would be. You know, I was one of the first people to be talking about this whole
everything you know is a lie. And the people who are really in control are.
But this show is so great.
Can we turn on the lights for once?
And it's actually really funny. Clever writing. Whoever made this is awesome. But it is literally so full of occult symbolism and just weird stuff. Like the weirdest stuff that I've thought of. Like, look. This show is so funny. I love how they do this. They're so funny. They think everyone's stupid. Oh, whoops, I didn't get there in time. Or I went too far, I mean. I get excited.
In the world, can you manage to show up on time?
Reagan Ridley, you are so smart, but your people...
Look, oh, look, there's that. And then there's a symbol for Moloch and a two-headed lamb, which I'm assuming is some kind of... Oh, no, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That might actually be the seven-eyed lamb from Revelation, the symbol of Enoch, right there, I think. It's either Enoch, Jesus, some unknown, the Archangel Michael. I don't know, I have a ton of theories. Like, I've actually had some weird cult people come up to me and ask me stuff like, if I'm Enoch... And then I had one come up to me, and they were saying I'm John the Baptist, and I'm like, I play along with it. I did, but now I regret doing that because I'm terrified, because now I know this stuff is like 90% certain this stuff's real. But anyways, watch this preview, and then I'm gonna shut up.
People skills. Woof.
Everyone remember to do time card.
That's why I brought in someone to co-lead the team.
Red Hand, thrilled to be serving whoever gives me approval.
You're just some yes man.
Yes man.
These people are trying to push you out of the company just like he did to me.
Dad, you weren't pushed out. You were fired. You almost exposed the deep state because you wanted a ride to Wetzel's Pretzels. You're lucky I called the snipers off. Gary, no. No. Ha ha. Save it for stand-up night, Gary.
I know that I could make the world a better place. If I didn't have to deal with all...
I wish somebody involved in this was trying to make the world a better place, but seems to me like they're trying to destroy it.
Look this.
The drone throne!
What the hell? Are you all high?
Was I?
Oh, God. Wake up, sheeple!
Welcome to Inhuman Resources. I'm Mr. Mothman. I'm a Mothman.
Getting kind of sick of all the feedback on my personality.
I've worked my whole life for this job, and I run the shit out of this office. But HR.
Gosh, when I was in school, if I
wouldn't
know this stuff was real, I would have tried so hard in school. And I'd be like running some kind of organization. But now, instead, I'm like trying to expose them because I just.
But you do want to take over the world, right?
Everyone wants that.
Honey, denial isn't just a river I tried to steal with a laser.
I don't think they're being honest with us about who's really in control.
Yeah, but definitely check that out. It's on Netflix. It's called Inside Job. Anyways, read the Tao Te Ching. It'll change your life.